Welcome back to the XL Energy Center and the Class 3A semifinal match between number 3 seed Champlin Park and number 2 seed Eagan. Each team just 4 losses on the season, and this will be a good one here today.
Absolutely, going to see some great athletic volleyball. Quarterfinal matches were decent yesterday, but here's where the rubber meets the road. One of these teams is going to be playing for a championship at 5 o'clock tomorrow. The other going to be playing for third a little earlier in the day. We'll see the starters here.
Marissa Battendahl-Vidal, Allie Miller, Janae Alderson, Anna Krimble, Sydney Hilly, Izzy Ashburn, and Caitlin Weimerskirch. Same lineup we've seen for them for several matches. And it's been a good lineup for them all season, especially as they've kind of settled into that last part of the season. And a look at the Eagan Wildcats, McKenna Melville, and Long, Allie Murphy, Alyssa Doucette, Ellie Huseman, Bree Orr, and Taylor Olstead is their libero.
Scary part about that lineup is, I believe, 0 seniors in that starting 7. So the whole starting lineup's coming back next year.
Players being introduced down on the floor right now. Prior Lake, as you mentioned, already advanced. Tell me about their match against Roseville earlier here.
You know, it came down to who wanted to be physical at the end. Probably, even though they don't announce it, runner-up for Miss Volleyball, Ella Francis from Prior Lake, outside hitter, just put the team on her back late in set 2 when they were down and needed a comeback. McGraw, as she was against Hopkins on Thursday, pretty outstanding. Roseville gave it everything they had. Middle hitter, Hain, I think is her last name, had a great match. Olivia Garvey had a great match. Bree Maloney had a great match. Haley Kauth, the 6-year libero for Roseville, also played very, very well. But at the end of the day, there was just too much offense coming from Prior Lake, and it looked easier than it was for them in the 3-0 sweep.
So they're into the championship match, either Champlin Park or Eagan, playing them 5 o'clock Saturday afternoon here at XL Energy Center. The Champlin Park on the road at Navy uniforms today. They are the lower seeded team, and Eagan in the royal blue with the green trim.
Back in the day when this was done in black and white, that'd make for a problem.
It would make it a little hard, yes.
But are we in HD yet? Is that happening?
Yes.
Excellent. We are. Well, now they should have no problem watching it. We are going to get amazing fan support from both of these teams. White out on both sides, it looks like, from the student sections. Crazy chaos. I know if I was a parent, it'd be a tough match to watch and try and focus in, but it's going to be loud and proud and good stuff all the way through.
And you see the Eagan fans across the way from where we're sitting here at the press table, and the Champlin Park fans both in front of our cameras, which can be a problem at times, and right behind where Andy and I are sitting. We are underway. Eagan with the first serve of the match. Hilly bumping it over. Set to the middle. But down on the Champlin Park side, it's a point for Eagan. Boy, they get the big attack from the middle, as you mentioned. They've got a lot of hitters that can put the ball in play, don't they?
Yeah, you see here, Orta Doucette. They've been playing together year-round for the last 2 years as they both were on the Northern Lights 16-1 team this past year. And they find each other in transition quite well, or with another big serve there.
And Ashburn couldn't get to that ball to get the set, and it's quickly 2-0 Wildcats. And point given right back on the serve by Orr, and it's 2-1 as Battendahl-Vidal will serve the first.
Orr's mother and I had a conversation. Apparently she missed like 7 or 8 serves in their section final, almost didn't get dinner.
We'll get the set here outside. Dug up by Alderson. Ashburn going outside to Hilly down. Back right side. Hilly spins it over. In the middle again. Doucette trying to push it, and does. Finds the open spot and gets herself her second kill.
Yeah, good spot by her pushing to the deep one corner. Allie Miller not quite in position to make that block, leaving the space open, and Doucette finds it. junior Hannah Hegwer into serve. Excuse me, I knew I'd get it eventually.
Champlin Park picks up their second point off a service error by the Wildcats.
It's a very effective serve-receive play the Rebels are using right there, allowing two missed serves. We'll like it.
Allow the net to help them a little bit on defense.
Right.
Brianna Gore is rotated in and will serve it up for the first time today. More to the middle to Murphy, gets blocked. No, tied at three.
Good vision there by the Rebels as they stay inside and get forehand strong on Miller's high two ball attack.
Laurel set it outside for Melville. Hilly digs it up. Ashburn back to Hilly. Got it down for a point.
Hilly just so good in transition there. She digs, works to get deep in the court, and then goes over the top of Melville. Melville, a libero during the club season, doing a nice job attacking for the Wildcats this year.
Back seven, and blocked by Champlin Park. They'll get another point.
Good service run here by Gore, the sophomore DS. See the attack there again. Doucette not able to get her feet to the ball, hits it into the net.
Outside Melville, spun it over the block and down for a point.
Surgical with that roll shot as Melville hides it very well. Gore not able to make the play.
McKenna Melville, just a sophomore. Andy mentioned no seniors in their rotation, no seniors at all on their roster. So presumably all of these girls will be back a year from now.
Melville, Wong, and Murphy all played on the same club team as well. Very talented, successful 15-1 team. Actually, Tara Lee played on that team as well, the Hopkins setter. And Prior Lakes Middle's Maddie Bremer. And Kayla Bear and libero CeCe McGraw. So seven of those 10 kids make the state tournament. Another big swing in the middle there from Hilly.
Puts it in a spot that's tough to play, isn't it? When
yeah.
You hit it that deep in the court.
You go that deep in the court, she swings it from the middle. Very difficult to defend.
Almighty back to the middle, over by Olstead. Here's Hilly. Back set this time for Allie Miller, and then she got that down for a kill.
Allie Miller in a great rhythm there from Hilly. Let's take another look. Jump set going against the flow does Hilly to Miller there. Block has no chance, the freshman Huseman.
No, 7-4 Rebels here to start the first set. Or quick set gets blocked. And that one drops in for a point for Eagan.
Most high school teams have a tough time defending the last 2-3 feet of the court. We see it there again as Orr pushes an easy ball, and it's kind of tried to get willed out of bounds from the Champlin Park side.
Kennedy Orr, just a seventh grader, younger sister of Bree Orr, in and serving for Eagan. Here's Alderson from Hilly. Back row in the front, and knocked down for a point by Bree Orr.
I like Alderson's idea here to go after Kennedy Orr, the seventh grader, but ball gets set out to big sister Bree, who pushes it deep down the line.
Kennedy Orr was, what, 12 for most of the season?
Yeah,
12 years old?
Turned 13 at the section final and playing like it's her fourth or fifth year on varsity right now, doing some really nice things. Big swing from Bree Orr.
Weimer skirts the dig. Here's Alderson. Goes deep, Olstead playing it back to the middle and over by Bree Orr. Hilly back to Allie Miller. That's her second kill of the set.
Miller having a nice day to start here. We see Hilly again find her behind. Bree Orr out of position to blocking there. Great swing from Miller.
Weimer skirts serving, served it wide. It's 8-7.
Tight volleyball right now. Seems to be pretty smooth and fluid from both sides of the net. Should be Melville back to serve.
Yes. Hilly for Alderson.
Just wide.
He missed. And we're tied at 8.
Alderson going to need to settle in here. This is that crazy rotation again where Hilly's stacked in the back of the middle of the court. Typically in this rotation, you would have your opposite stacked at the net, but with Alderson being such a good serve receiver, they need her passing all six rotations.
Brior, Hilly dug that ball up. Tipped over by Vatndal Vidal. Orr goes outside through the blockers, and it's a Eagan point. And Wong getting the kill.
Wong working hard in transition there. She goes inside out, drops it down for a point.
Hilly to Alderson, pushed it past the front line. Back set by Kennedy Orr. Brior attacking. Vatndal Vidal gets blocked by Brior. Rebels able to get it back over. Weimerskirch with a good play. And the Eagan player is up the point.
Kenna sets that ball and doesn't get up high enough. Anne Wong does what she can to try and find hands, but doesn't get it over the tape.
Ashburn, we've seen her have some big serves, Andy, throughout the postseason for Champlin Park.
Net violation on Champlin Park there. Point to Eagan, Huseman back to serve.
Elise Ellie Huseman, excuse me, serving here for the Wildcats. Alderson off the blockers, handled by Kennedy Orr. Here's Brior. Cross blocked by the Rebels. Eagan scrambling to get right back into position to play that. Vatndal Vidal over. Oh, what a play. One hand to be able to get that over by Wong. Here's Hilly attacking. And able to get it off with Doucette and down for a point. Good rally, some nice athletic plays, Andy, on both sides of the net.
Absolutely, and I like the finish there as Weimerskirch just pops that ball up for Hilly to swing out of the back row.
Alderson floating to serve over. Kennedy Orr, oh, Doucette with some power, able to pound that ball down.
Seventh grader Kennedy Orr finding Doucette flying across on that shake set off one leg. It's a beautiful find by the seventh grader.
Eagan back in front by a point. Here's Krimble in the middle.
Doucette in the net there. Point to Champlin.
Tied up at 11. Vatndal Vidal serving. Melville in the front row over by Doucette. Alderson up in the air to Hilly. Brior back, attack him down for a kill. Murphy for Eagan.
I like Orr's ability right now to go counter flow. So she's moving towards the outside hitter, flicks it back. She's moving back, she moves back, she throws it to the outside. A lot of counter flow causing the middle blocker for Champlin to second guess where she's going.
Hagwar back to serve. He'll tap it over, dug up by Olstead nicely. Brior back. Ashburn for Hilly. Olstead another dig. Brior outside, tapped over by Murphy. Momentum, I think, carried her into the net. No, we had a Champlin Park player in the net. So it's a point for Eagan.
Trimble a little aggressive trying to block that tip shot, ends up catching the net.
Eagan by two. Kelly gets blocked. Rebels will set it up again that side. This time gets it down over the blockers. And a kill for Sydney Hilly.
Great swing by Hilly, the junior. She's scoring from everywhere in a variety of different ways. Here she goes hard cross court. Olstead out of position, thinks that ball's out of bounds. Lets it drop.
Gore trying to tie it up here for the Rebels. Melville's
wow.
Ball, Alderson, and over by Hilly after Weimerskirch had played. Doucette in the middle. Weimerskirch able to dig that ball. Double contact called on Champlin Park. Point for Eagan.
Great defensive effort by the Rebels. Alderson laying out early in that rally to keep it alive.
Arneson had a run to that ball and got there a little late to make a good pass. Goes an ace serve for the Wildcats.
Alderson just looks a little tired after the rally from that last one. Didn't get her feet there on that second one.
Olmstead service error. Third time that Egan's had one of those here in the first set.
Here we see Kathy Gillen, head coach for the Wildcats, Hall of Fame member in the Coaches Association. Won a state title just a couple years ago. Definitely the leader of the pack here for the Cats.
Kill for Murphy and Egan. And the Wildcats up by three.
I like the Wildcats' game plan here to go back set quite a few and get Hilly and Alderson jumping to block. Maybe they're hoping to tire him out here before too long.
Hilly to Miller. Cuts it across with Egan ready for it here. Prior, she gets blocked. Point Champlin Park. Claflin with the block.
Claflin and Miller just camped on this ball. Or unloads right into the platform of the hands right there. Great block by the Rebels. Back within two.
Kennedy Orr across, Prior tapping it. Claflin got it back, Olmstead now in the middle. The kill for Egan by Huseman.
Huseman works hard in transition here. They get her the ball back and she drops it to the deep five for a point.
17-14. 3 points seems like a huge lead, doesn't it, the way this match has gone so far?
It's been a battle. 3 points, yeah, exactly. We haven't seen a three-point run yet by either team.
Kill for Batten-Dalvidal to get Champlin Park back to within two.
Batten-Dalvidal very surgical with that spot. She had to go a little bit of thumb down here to cut that ball around the block and outside of Olmstead. Great, great swing.
Izzy Ashburn serving. Handled by Melville in the middle. Huseman gets the kill.
Another quick side out here.
Yep.
Good pass. Orr sees Huseman coming in. Finds her in rhythm. Nice big swing. It's got to be three or four kills for the freshman middle already.
Back to a three-point lead. And Huseman misses on the serve.
That's the, my friend Dave Manka and I talk about the worst route that middles run. She served and she was already halfway off the court. She knew she missed that one early. Settle in, take care of the ball.
Alderson, a flow to serve over. Kennedy Orr back for Prior. Dug up nicely by Ashburn. Alderson attacking from the middle. Prior again. Alderson gets a hand on it, but out of play.
That or-to-or connection seems to be working quite well for the Wildcats.
And it's Prior back to serve.
Time
Kennedy
out,
Orr back out. Champlin Park will use its first time out here of the opening set. Trailing by
clean
three.
Volleyball.
Yeah.
Very good volleyball on both sides of the net. I think yesterday one of the matches we did, after two sets, one team had 30-some kills. Both teams could be in that situation here. Both teams earning points, earning points, earning points. Not a lot of giveaway, not a lot of errors. And what I like about it is they're scoring in a variety of ways. We've seen Krimble have a few nice kills. We saw that Miller and Claflin block for the Rebels. A couple service points as well, putting pressure from the end line. Wildcats doing the same thing, getting the middles involved, getting Orr involved. We've got Murphy and Wong with a couple kills each. Balanced attack on both sides. This is the type of volleyball you should come to expect at a state tournament.
Wildcats at 19, leading by three. Prior serving. Ashburn, Hilly through the blockers, gets an important point back for the Rebels.
He just wills it to happen at times, it seems. Like, it doesn't matter what's going on. You see here Ashburn to Hilly, and Hilly goes off the inside hand of Doucette in the seam of the block.
And all the goal. Serving Prior outside. Murphy gets the kill.
Sophomore Murphy there unloading on a ball quite well. Middle blocker is drawn as Krimble has to pay attention to Doucette. Murphy one-on-one is going to win that matchup.
Hegwer back in. She'll serve here for Egan. Ashburn to Hilly off the blockers. Hilly able to handle that. Now it's Crimble on the right side. Spins it over. Murphy attacking for Eagan. Ashburn to Hilly. Off the block. Point for Champlin Park.
You see Melville there kind of grabbing her right hand. I think that went off not comfortably. Hilly does a great job abusing the outside hand there.
Rebels need a little run here. They trail by two at 20-18. Rior outside. Melville attacking. Weimerskirch got it to the net. Hilly wins that ball against Doucette. Over by Rior. Weimerskirch to the floor. Hilly handled by Brior. We play on. Here's Murphy. Too strong.
Great rally there by the Rebels as Hilly wins a joust. Weimerskirch lays out on a center dump, and Hilly rolls one deep and putting the Wildcats out of system, leading to the out of system hitting error.
Or to Melville. Trying to just tap it over, didn't get enough on that ball. Now we're tied at 20.
There's a couple errors there in a row from the Wildcats. Sophomores maybe feeling a little bit of the pressure here, tied up at 20.
Gore serves. In the middle, attacked by Murphy, Alderson, Weimer, Skur, Chile. Good effort to get to the ball, but can't get it over the net.
Great hustle from Champlin there. Good touch off the high two ball. Murphy swings, Alderson gets a touch. Weimerskirch, no give up in her. And Hilly, because it's not been whistled dead yet, gonna make great effort on it.
Ashburn to Miller, taps it over. Olstead got that. Brior in the middle. Hughesman with a big kill. It's 22-20 Wildcats.
Great decision here after the slide set from Champlin, knowing that the middle blocker isn't going to get back or finds Hughesman on a quick set in front. Beautiful decision by the junior setter or great swing by the freshman middle. I love the effort we're seeing from the Rebels right now. Trimble working hard there, just not enough time to get back. Low pass, low set, quick swing. Everybody's getting their money's worth. I don't know how many times I'm going to get to say that today, but this is definitely a set for the ages. Eagan jumped out early. Champlin caught him at 20, and now we see a two-point run from the Wildcats. Junker calls a timeout, going to reset the troops. We see the assistant coaches actually running what's going on right now. Might be one of those rah-rah, rile them up type timeouts, which as a coach, every once in a while, you know that's what your team needs. We'll see what happens off this timeout. Look for Hilly on a 32 here, and Miller running behind.
Olstead serving out of the timeout. Ashburn across to Hilly. 22-21. Hilly getting the kill out of the timeout for the second time in this set.
Good decision by Izzy Ashburn to get her the ball on that three set as the right side block was camped on the antenna again.
Hilly serves long.
Uncharacteristic error for the Metro Player of the Year there. Normally late, she's as cold as ice. Misses the serve there. We'll see how she runs her offense.
21 Eagan.
Hilly going to go to Alderson here.
And gets it for a point. 23-22.
Kenna Orr is going to set Brior on this one. And it's one of those things where once you watch volleyball for long enough, it's not about being telepathic. It's just knowing how games are won.
Kennedy Orr across to Brior. Yeah, that wasn't touched by Champlin Park. Off the tape, but then out. And a point for Champlin Park, and Eagan takes timeout. We're tied at 23.
Another little mini run here, 23-23. Game to two off the timeout. I like the idea here. Great serve. Melville in a little bit of trouble. Kenna Orr doesn't quite get that ball pushed the way she wants it. Bree sees line is open and goes crossbody to hit it, but because it catches tape and she doesn't get a full arm swing on it, a spin on that ball knocks it out of bounds. great, calm play by the Rebels. Off the timeout here, look for either Huseman running in front on that shake set or the ball going to Orr again. If Orr tries to take that ball down the line, Hilly will wear it and look for her to get set in transition.
23 all here in set one. Kennedy Orr going back to Brior. Weimer-Skirch up for Battendall. Vidal gets blocked. Hilly, you got a foot on it and over by Claflin. Brior swings and misses wide.
Sit Hilly, because it's a job. The look on her face, like, just shut up. We were supposed to do that. Play volleyball. That's the level that kid can play at all the time.
Kennedy Orr back for Melville. Taps it over. Weimer-Skirch got it. At Melvidal from Hilly. Brior again from Kennedy Orr. Hilly back for Alderson. Gets blocked. We're tied at 24.
Banger's gonna bang is the phrase we coaches use, and that's what we're gonna see here. We're gonna see the big kids taking the swings the rest of the way. Orr gets pushed out of position. We get a nice cross-court swing, block. Big cover there from Hilly from a couple points ago. Wong, big swing, touched.
Brior in the middle for Huseman. Battendall Vidal played that. Hilly back for Claflin and over. Weimer-Skirch, Claflin across, off Brior, and a point for Champlin Park.
I like the out-of-system roll shot here we get, causing all sorts of problems for Orr. Wanting to take the pressure off her little sister there kind of cuts her off. Timeout, Eagan, 25-24, Champlin with their first lead of the set. It couldn't come at a better time. I'm so impressed with the level both teams are playing at, playing clean volleyball. We see John Yonker pulling Ashburn out, probably giving her, this is the order of importance of where we're gonna set the ball. Know who's gonna be getting it for them and know the matchups we have on our side. Eagan playing that emotional card timeout. Here we see Gillen talking with seventh grader Kenna Orr. And a Hall of Fame coach is probably the only person that can talk to a seventh grader. Down 24-25 in set one of a state semifinal. I don't know what you say to the kid. You can't give her too much information. She turned 13 a week ago. You got a senior, you can get at her, you can tell her exactly what's gonna happen. Maybe they're talking about puppies. I have no idea. We'll see what happens. Ashburn to serve here.
Trying to close it out here for Champlin Park. Yeah, not yet. Brior dumps it over the front line in for a point. 25 all.
Great decision, Kenna setting older sister Bree there, who tips it right into the campfire. Huseman, who ran into some trouble from the service line last time back, to serve at 25s.
Ashburn back to Alderson. Back row, Egan keeps it alive and over by Melville. Weimer-Skirch for Alderson again, tapping it over. Brior to the middle, Kennedy Orr outside. Swinging down for a point. The kill for Wong. And Eagan now at set point.
Interesting decision there to set the sophomore outside, and Wong comes through in the clutch. 26-25 Eagan.
Ellie Huseman trying to give Eagan a 1-0 lead. All goes back to Alderson. In the middle over Krimble. Alderson again swings and too strong. And Eagan wins set one, 27-25.
Went to Alderson in the well for about the fifth time. Let's watch that whole point. Good serve, moving Hilly inside. Back set to Alderson. She roll shots to keep it alive. Another dig from Huseman. We get another back set to Alderson. She's a little excited. Line is open and she overswings it. 27-25. Great volleyball. Both sides of the net. We're in for a great one here, John.
We'll take a break. Come back. Set two. Class 3A volleyball semifinals from the XL Energy Center on 12 Sports in a moment.
eating disorder feels like having another person inside your head. It kind of built this wall around me.
The main thing that we needed was hope.
Your age, your gender, your ethnicity, eating disorders don't discriminate. They can strike anyone. The National Eating Disorders Association has the information and resources to steer people and their families toward the road to recovery.
Call or visit the NIDA website today for help and hope.
You watch Channel 12 at home. Why not on the go? Channel 12 is online at 12.tv. Watch on your phone, on your tablet. Channel 12 is your local source wherever you go. Just log on to 12.tv. Check out our videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on Twitter, like us on Facebook, and even watch live events via live stream. So don't wait. Stay up to date with Channel 12 and 12.tv, your local source.
The world is online, and we're all connected. While there's a lot to explore and discover, we each need to do our part to keep the internet safe. Cybersecurity starts with you. Learn how you can stay safe online at dhs.gov/stopthinkconnect.
Eagan, the number 2 seed, defeating number 3 seed Champlin Park 27-25 in the first set here. A terrific match. First set, Sydney Hilly with 7 kills leading the Rebels. For Eagan, 5 kills apiece for Brior and Allie Murphy.
Hilly has a set like she had in that first one where she goes 7-0-15 and hits 467. There's no way Champlin doesn't win set two. That's just a great individual effort from her. Good team effort from both sides. We'll see what happens coming out of this set.
Eagan winning that first one. Only one set, Andy, but it already reminds me of that state quarterfinal I did a year ago here between Champlin Park and Roseville, where every game was just like that first one, all the way to 5. Ready to go here in set 2. Champlin Park, Janae Alderson will serve to get us underway. Brior from Murphy. First point to Eagan.
Good swing and serve receive there from Murphy. She does a really nice job getting her body in position and finding the seam in the block.
Hegler back in. She's serving here for Eagan, trying to put them up 2-0. Outside it goes. Hilly dug up by Olstead in the middle. The second blocked by Trimble.
Trimble jacked right now to get after that ball. One of 2 seniors on the team, and she wants to see this team make it to the state championship.
Brior all the way across for Melville. Alderson, the Hilly. Handled back row by Hegwer. And Melville gets blocked. Trimble getting up again along with Hilly on that left side, left defensive side for Champlin Park.
Great block by Krimble and Hilly there.
Serve long by Vattendahl Vidal. And we're tied at 2.
Tied at 2. Good effort from both sides so far to start set 2 again.
Ashburn to Hilly. Sydney Hilly's having herself a match so far.
Yes, she is. She gets up on this ball, bounces it. Olstead gets a touch, but doesn't really want much to do with that swing. Nice, aggressive ball.
Brior outside. Melville pounds it down. Daughter of head coach Kathy Gillen, McKenna Melville, the sophomore.
We see a great draw there from Huseman as the middle blocker for Champlin has to stick around going one-on-one.
Kennedy Orr back in. She serves here. Here's Hilly. Off the tape and down. Point Champlin Park. Four three Rebels with Hilly serving. Three Orr from Kennedy Orr off the blockers. Point for Eagan.
You see a good commit block there from Champlin. They're in the right position, just not able to finish the play.
Hilly back set for Miller. Kennedy Orr got it up to Brior. What a point for Eagan. The sisters combining.
Good rally there. Melville picks it up. Kenna keeps it alive, and Brior pushes it deep for the point.
Eagan in front with Melville off the serve. Here's Alderson trying to tie it up. Brior got it over. Alderson again, and gets the kill.
Alderson had a little struggle finding a rhythm in set one, gets a set, and then gets what we call a reset, where they give her the same ball again, and she's able to finish on the second opportunity. See Olstead and Melville talking about who's got that seam as they bumped into each other on the last one.
Kennedy Orr back for Brior over Weimer Skirch. Hilly, Battendall, the doll, handled in the back row. Here's Wong with the swing. Hilly back set, Alderson, kill for Champlin Park.
That's Weimer Skirch's 10th dig already in the match. Here we are, barely into set two. She's doing a really nice job covering a lot of court, letting the hitters do their job. Her and Gore controlling the backcourt pretty well right now.
Champlin Park, last 2 points have put them back in front. There's Wong, ties it up.
That is a monster set here. We see, it was Brior. I didn't think Kenna at 13 had the arm strength to finish that ball. It was Brior. Pushes it all the way from about 15 feet off the net across for the big kill from Wong.
Scramble this ball. Hilly did. Alderson got it over. Brior for Wong again. Too strong.
Another good choice there. Orr gets her feet to the ball and delivers a strong set outside. Wong not able to finish that swing. Hits it long. Point Champlin.
Ashburn. On the serve. Here's Brior attacking. Handled by Hilly. Front row, Vattendahl, the doll. Across the front row, Wong. Dug up by Weimer Skirch again. Hilly will push it across. Kennedy Orr for Brior. Wong one more time. This time it's in for a point for Egan.
Wong playing high-level volleyball right now. She uncorks on yet another ball. Sophomore outside, not a real strong hitter most of the season, more of a shot hitter and kind of an 0-2 type player. Really doing some nice things for the Wildcats.
Brior with the service error. Champlin Park back in front, 8-7. And Egan ties it back. It's, you know, back and forth, isn't it? Murphy, another kill.
Yeah, we'll see this again as because early on in set one, they were able to find the middle on that shake play. Crimble's going to have to commit to it just about every time, and Murphy's going to go one-on-one.
Hilly pounds one home. Team's trading points. Rebels in front by one.
Hilly doing Hilly things here as she goes cross court again for another kill. I believe that is probably her 10th of the match.
I like that, doing Hilly things.
No other way to describe it. Everybody in Madison, Wisconsin knows what I'm talking about. The junior going to play for the Badgers in a couple years, or going to be playing at Iowa after the 2017 high school season as well.
Brior, 4 to 2 seconds, blocked back by Trimble and Hilly. Troubles by two.
Big block there, nice positioning from the middle.
Brior to the middle to Murphy. Alderson able to dig that ball up. Ashburn tight to the net, over by Trimble. Melville got it over. Ashburn to Hilly. Murphy. Back row handled by Vattendahl Vidal. Over by Hilly again. Here's Ashburn. Back to Hilly. And Olstead handling that. Brior dumping it over. Long rally here. Alderson up front to Hilly. Too strong.
Hats off to up ref Robbie Goodman as she lets a couple questionable calls go and lets the athletes decide the point. Hats off to her letting the volleyball happen on the court.
Ashburn back to Trimble. Over Olstead to the middle. Brior blocked in the middle by Miller and blocked by Huseman. Did it again. And the point for Champlin Park.
Miller saying, get on, I've got this net. The middle play for Champlin Park is quite remarkable right now. When things are out of system, in rhythm, Bree Orr and Kenna Orr able to draw middle and go one-on-one to the pins. But when things aren't in system, the middle's for Champlin doing really well.
Brior to the middle, pushed over by Huseman. Almost a miscommunication there. Now here's Hilly, gets blocked. And a point for Eagan.
Melville and Huseman do a great job closing there. Hilly not able to finish her swing as she's kind of going inside out a little bit and hits that ball into the block and it's stuffed down.
Wildcats back to it in one. Kennedy Orr serving. That's burn for Hilly. Another point for Eagan, and it's 11-11.
Hilly with the attacking error there. I like the idea as little Kenna Orr was already up to set. It was open. She just missed it.
Kennedy Orr in the middle, tipped over by Huseman. Ashburn runs to that ball to Hilly, and gets this one in.
That's the shot she wanted last time. Was able to get it down for a point this time, and she'll go back to serve. Champlin Park up 12-11. Here we see it there just over the outstretched hands of Kenna Orr, getting some advice from Kathy Gillen right now on how to stay and play defense first, knowing somebody else can take that ball.
Claflin back in for Champlin Park. Ball at the net. Alderson tips it down. Yes. 13-11 Rebels. Hilly gives the point back. A couple service errors for her. Had one late in that first set when the ball hit long, and then this one here into the net.
She'll recover well. She always does.
Melville serving for the tie. Hilly outside to Alderson. And back to a two-point Rebels lead.
Great delivery there. You see Hilly jump set, draw middle. Every time she jump sets, the middle for Eagan seems to be staying. I don't know if that's something in the scouting report they saw or what, but Alderson going to take advantage of that seam all day.
Weimerskirt serves. To Wong across back row. Hilly back set Alderson. Kill for Champlin Park.
Alderson coming alive. 15-12, Champlin Park lead.
Skirch pushing it over on the serve in this ball and nicely dumped to the back corner by Brior.
Good spot for the junior there. She sees the last spot open deep in the corner and drops it.
Lily Cross, Vattendahl with all gets blocked. Alderson.
Under is the call on Vattendahl Vidal. Eagan back within one.
Here's Huseman. Serves it out. 16-14 Champlin Park. Midway through the second set, Eagan won the first one, 27-25.
Be a good time for a run here from Izzy Ashburn.
Good first serve. And going for Champlin Park. Ooh.
That's questionable. The call is back row block on Orr. Crowd thought that Krimble might have been over.
And another good serve by Ashburn in the middle, off the tape, it rolls out. And a timeout for Champlin Park.
Things getting away slowly here from the Eagan Wildcats. Gillen gonna talk it over with the squad. Good volleyball here from Champlin. They're firing on all cylinders. Good serving, getting Eagan out of system and questioning what they're gonna do next with the ball. I like the fact that Egan's gonna stay with the middles here, but when you're serving that well, it's predictable how you're gonna have to set the middle. Champlin in a good spot, block-wise, they're doing some really nice things. When your first when your serve and your attacks put your opponent out of system, blocking gets easy. When blocking gets easy, then defense gets easy. When defense gets easy, then suddenly your setter's got all sorts of options. It's amazing how every piece of the game kind of gets interconnected. Everything going Rebel way right now. 18-14, they're up on Eagan as they trail one set to none, but up in set two here.
Their biggest lead of the day, 4 points here. Ashburn serves, long.
Good timeout by the Hall of Fame coach there.
18-15. And Brior serves. And, oh, got the back line. Nice serve for Orr, and it's 18-16.
Just like that, two quick service points. Eagan back within two.
Ashburn back for Alderson, and the block long, and Doucette 3 points very quickly, and Champlin Park takes timeout.
Yeah, good serve here by Orr. Ball comes off. The set is where it needs to be. Alderson overruns it a little bit, hits it right into the block, and that ball's stuffed back down. Eagan, after trailing by four, gets the miss serve off a timeout, then the service ace, then the block. Three big points in a very big hurry with not much volleyball happening in order to get there. Champlin just settling the troops down, talking it over, trying to figure out what needs to happen next. Everybody going eye contact, which about 3 years ago, I realized how important that is. When I played sports, you didn't need to look a guy in the eye. You just tell him you got the next ball and away you go. There's something about volleyball where that is a mandatory piece.
Ashburn back to Alderson. Long again. Eagan has come back to tie it up at 18.
Senior with back-to-back errors there. Seat there.
Time to Helio, push it deep. Olstead up to the front rope. Brior, right side attack, Murphy. Puts Eagan in front. They've got five straight.
Big swing here from Murphy. Good reversal from Orr. Cross court in between Hilly and Ashburn. Hilly's got to make that play there. Let Ashburn go run the offense.
And that's served by Brior is long. Champlin Park catches a break. Tied at 19. They get the side out.
Quick game to six here. Hilly back in the front row, exactly where Champlin needs her.
Murphy, back row Alderson. Ashburn across to Hilly, and off of Brior. Champlin Park back in front.
What I think is happening right now, we'll see Hilly take this big swing and Orr not in position to dig it. I think Orr is starting to get in her own head a little bit, knowing that Orr versus Hilly is kind of one of the headlines of this match. She's got to just play Eagan volleyball and see what happens. Ooh, big swing from Murphy.
Good dig up by Weimerskirch. And over by Hilly. Brior runs up to that ball. Murphy across for Wong. Spins it over. Whistle.
Net violation on Champlin Park. 20-20. In to serve is Hegwer.
First to five, Andy.
Love it.
Hilly from Ashburn, dug up by Olstead. Back set, Melville. That ball dug up to the net. Ashburn trying to play it off the net and couldn't do it.
Ashburn not having the faith in her hand she needs there. This ball dug up. She's fast enough. She should get there and get her hands on that ball. I think she would have had Krimble with nobody blocking.
Ashburn runs to that ball. Hilly will swing it across. Melville for Brior will push it deep. Ashburn to Hilly. Hill and Champlin Park is tied at a 21.
Hilly doing Hilly things. Goes deep cross court, misses in between Hegwer and Olstead. 22-20, oh excuse me, 21-21 here.
Matt Melvidal serving. Brior over by Murphy.
Not at this point. That cannot happen at this point in the tournament. It's a free ball opportunity. Alderson thinking that Hilly's going to grab it. Hilly thinking Alderson's got it, and that ball drops.
Hilly's got to back up for that ball. It gets to it. Brior in the middle. And a block by Miller. And gets the point for her team. Able to block Huseman again.
How good is Miller right here? Block and then stays in the play, just locked in. If that wouldn't have been an under, I think she wanted another one. Miller playing high level volleyball. 22-22.
Four serves. Front row Ashburn across to Hilly. Yes, wow.
Hilly surgical here around the block. Olstead standing behind the block. She's got to read that, get outside it, and make a play there. Big swing for Hilly. I believe like her 13th kill of the match. Timeout. Eagan. Hands on the hip as Gillen not happy with the effort on that defensive play. Champlin, everything going their way. They've got Hilly still playing big in the front row. Gore. Good serving, putting pressure on the Wildcats here. And even though it's 23-22, it feels like it's a bigger lead for Champlin. They've gotten the breaks, they've had the momentum pretty much this entire set, barring that 4-point run at about 20-16. Good volleyball all the way through. Right now, John Yunker talking to his kids about we finish here. We don't play long. We don't get into long rallies. We get opportunities. We take advantage of big swings. I'd like to see a little cleaner effort from Alderson off this timeout. She seems a little out of sorts. Like she, I don't know if she's trying to do too much or what it is. But if she's gonna be seeing her team into the final, she's gonna have to play at another level.
Rebels up by one, Gore serving. And to even this match at a set apiece. Oh, it gave it back on the service there. Tied at 23. Kennedy Orr in to serve for Eagan.
Seventh grader serving at 23-23 in set two.
And service there by the younger Orr, and now it's set point for Champlin Park.
Back in.
Claflin in for Ashburn. Hilly trying to serve it out here for the Rebels. Kennedy Orr for Brior. Ties it up.
Brior unloading on that ball. Hilly playing a little self-defense there, 24-24.
Melville trying to put Eagan back in front. Hilly outside to Alderson, 25-24. Another set point coming for the Rebels. Potential set point. Weimerskirch serves it across. Rior hit and tipped in the back. And a point for Eagan off of Gore.
Gore playing some really nice volleyball down the stretch here, 25-25.
Huseman serves. Gore, Attendall Vidal, and now set point for Eagan.
John Younger gonna call a timeout, settle him down. Gore in a little bit of freak out mode right now here. She misses the serve and then out of position on a dig and gets aced. She needs to just relax and recognize it was her serve that got them going here in set two. She's done a really nice job all season for the Rebels. It's simple volleyball at this point. Take care of first contact, clean it up. I would love to see Alderson on a plus or a two ball. Maybe change the serve receive a little bit. See what it looks like.
Megan won the first set 27-25. They're at 26-25 right now. Ellie Huseman, a freshman serving for the Wildcats.
Pressure opportunity.
Gore handles this one. Hilly in the middle to Alderson, taps it over. Rior off the front wall and down. Eagan rallies to win set two, 27-25 again, and they're up 2-0.
Great volleyball from the Wildcats down the stretch. Rebels had them. Opportunity after opportunity after opportunity, not able to close out the set. When Hilly gets to the back row, Eagan gets another set of another little energy boost because they know they don't have to face her in the front row anymore, and they push to finish there, coming back from behind to finish out set two. Same score, 27-25.
We'll take a break. We're back with more high school volleyball from the state tournament in St. Paul in a moment.
There's a shelter pet who wants to meet you. Meet one today. Visit theshelterpetproject.org. Adopt.
Sharing your passion starts with taking that first step. Take Lindsay, for example. Her first step was taking free TV classes at Northwest Community Television. Right away, she received professional training and now has the tools and skills necessary to produce her own show. She's turning dreams into realities right from her own home. And best of all, she's sharing her passion with members of her community and beyond. Share your passion. Visit nwct.org.
There's a shelter pet who wants to meet you. Meet one today. Visit theshelterpetproject.org. Adopt.
Eagan up 2-0 on Champlin Park here in the semifinal match that would send the winner to the championship game tomorrow against Prior Lake. Be a first state tournament appearance at a final for the Rebels. But they've got some work to do, Andy.
Absolutely. You know, they had that set. They feel like that one slipped through their fingers. But they're not done. They didn't get to this point in the season by dropping two sets and being done. They if that was the case, they wouldn't even showed up for the section final after losing to Wayzata twice. This team has grit. This team has fight. This team is the blue-collar squad left in the state tournament. We'll see what happens here as we start set three.
Early in the season, lost the first two sets to Prior Lake. And came back and won that night. Hilly tapping it over here. Ashburn across for Hilly. Gets blocked back. Weimerskirch gets a hand on it and over by Vattendahl-Vidal. Prior across for Wong. Ashburn goes to the floor to play that. And over by Hilly. Prior again. Back for Doucette, pushing it to the back row. Alderson had it. Here's Hilly from Ashburn. Champlin Park gets the first point on a long rally to start set three.
You see this ball, Ashburn to Hilly. Hilly with a great swing there. Murphy trying to reach high for it, but not as high as Hilly swings.
Wow, Murphy over. Ashburn got to the floor to get that ball. Nice play by the Rebels freshman to keep that ball alive. Now Wong attacking, gets the point for Eagan.
Ashburn going to the floor twice in the first 2 points. Love the effort there. Here we see Orr, and a great swing down the line there for the kill.
Hegwer serving for Eagan. It's Ashburn setting in the middle from middle for Miller. Hilly with the swing left side, kills Champlin Park.
Hilly's got that drop shot in front of Orr back into her arsenal, and here we see it again. Orr playing a little bit on her heels defensively, and Hilly with a smart swing for another Champlin Park point.
Her 15th kill of the match. Rior leads Eagan today with 11. Kill from Melville.
That's a ball I'd like to see Miller go up and get, that tight set. That ball's in the plane. She's got a right to it. But because she's watching, she's not able to get that ball or get out to close on the outside.
Ashburn to Hilly.
Melville saw it, just couldn't do anything about it. She was pushing on the middle blocker here to get inside, but Hilly just taking over as she does.
Rebels leading 3-2. Hilly outside, Alderson pounds it down.
Alderson gets that ball right where she needs it and swings down the line for a big kill. Good draw from Hilly again. Orr getting frustrated at her lack of defense there.
Rior from Melville got blocked. Wildcats recover. Weimerskirch, Alderson, back row. Handled by Hegwer in the front. Now Hughesman. The block, or the kill rather, for Eagan. And they're back within one.
Here we see the transition set to the middle to Hughesman, and not able to press our Claflin and Alderson.
Kennedy Orr serving, her team down by one here in set three, but they're up two sets to none. Alderson gets blocked by Hughesman and tied at four.
Alderson hits roll shot right into the hands of Hughesman. She's got to get the big girl pants on and start swinging like she did earlier in the year.
Back it goes, cross court by Miller. Front row, Brior, right to you, Andy, on the bounce.
I didn't even call the ball. That's on me. I'm better than that.
5-4 Rebels. Kennedy Orr over by Hughesman. Alderson lays out for that ball. Here's Vattendahl-Vidal over the blockers. Outside and over by Brior. Back row handled there. Vattendahl-Vidal over. Olsted with the dig. Here's Brior attacking.
Orr just gets this look about her when she's going to unload on a ball. I knew that was a kill before she even got set.
Five, five, tied up in set three with Melville serving. Only for Vattendahl-Vidal, too strong.
Off the hands, out of bounds.
We're going to talk about this point. I don't think it hit any hands there.
He snapped it right away.
Yeah.
Whatever he saw or didn't see, he saw it right away. But I like the idea here. Robbie bringing him over, double checking it, finding out what actually happened. She saw what she saw. She's going to stick with her no call there. 6-5 Eagan.
Wildcats with the 1-point lead. Trying to close off the Rebels in three here. Prior outside, long gets blocked, the clock landing wide. 7-5 Wildcats.
Nice swing.
Hilly for Vandal Vidal. Off of Kennedy Orr, and it's going to be a point for Champlin Park.
Ooh. Lift is the call. I don't think I've seen that before. That's it's an interesting one.
Rebels trail by a point. Ashburn serving. Rior got it set from her sister. Got it across. Here's Hilly from the middle. Ooh. Off of Kennedy Orr. Ashburn this time to Vattendahl. The doll really had to adjust to that ball. And then a nice job, Andy. Keeps it inside the antenna, off Huseman's hands and down.
She sees that Huseman's coming in late, and she throws it at her. And then Huseman, for some reason, tries to go after that ball when it's already out across the net. Let that one go and hope your back row can pick it up.
Long off the tape. Wow, by Hilly. Hilly. Over oh. by Krimble, but out.
Hilly starting to show a little frustration. The effort she's giving in that ball sent over and out of bounds.
Back it goes Alderson. Now Brior attacking. Hilly digs that ball up. Alderson blocked in the middle. Brior back throw handled by Hilly. Ashburn will set it for Vattendahl Vidal. Off Kennedy Orr, dumped over by Brior. Rebels were ready for it. Here's Hilly from the middle attacking. Brior, big swing in the middle. Knocked back by Trimble and Vattendahl Vidal. Point Champlin Park.
Great rally there. Couple big swings on both sides of the net. Ended with a solid double block.
Ball to the middle. Huge swing by Doucette for the kill.
Here we see Doucette. It's the same play. It's that shake, but she pushes a little ways, and Doucette stops the route a little short of Kenna Orr, and we see Krimble there blocking right in front of Orr.
Krimble. Really got the attack. Krimble in the middle against Doucette and wins that battle.
We are going to see a lot of Hilly right here. That level that she's playing at right now, I wouldn't, if you set anybody else, call a timeout and remind everybody who's going to get this ball.
Vattendahl Vidal handled by Olsteb. Up in the air, Murphy off the blockers. Ashburn, Alderson, and here's Hilly. Reord, Murphy across, ooh. Missed on that.
A little bit of a mishandle there as Murphy tries to do a little bit too much with an out-of-system ball. She's just got to put that up and hittable.
10-9 Rebels with Vattendahl Vidal back again to serve and aced it.
Vattendahl Vidal, lethal from the service line there. That's a great spot. She goes cross, deep one into the corner. Olsted willing that ball out of bounds, but to no avail.
And then gives that one back, though, with a service error. And so Eagan get the side out. They trail 11-10.
Good run there by Vattendahl Vidal.
We're serving. Ashburn for Hilly blocked. Got up by Weimer-Skirch. Back to Hilly again. This time taps it over the blockers. Olsted, Eagan scrambling a little bit, but they play it well. Weimer-Skirch to Hilly again. Back row Olsted, Brior in the middle, push deep, and a kill for Doucette.
Doucette never was in the middle of the court. The entire rally she spent standing in front of Hilly, and they get her the ball in transition there, and she puts it down to tie it up at 11.
Hegler with a service error, 12-11, Rebels.
Finally an exhale from Champlin as things are starting to pressure up on him.
Whitney Anderson into the match for the first time today. Saw her a little bit at the end of the match yesterday against North Branch. Comes in to serve, and unfortunately a service error. And we are tied at 12.
Tight game, as were the first two. Lots of good volleyball on both sides. Olstead to serve.
The junior puts it in play for the Wildcats. Here's Ashburn. Sets up Miller. Across, and Weimer skirts with a long run to get to that ball. Hilly pounds one down.
Hilly puts her team back up by one here on another just monster swing.
Rebels by one at 13-12. Prior backs up Murphy. Point Eagan. Now Murphy comes out.
Big swing from Murphy there, catching a late Claflin closing.
Kennedy Orr's back in, she'll serve it. Set to Alderson off the blockers. In the middle over, Alderson playing it. Played deep by Hilly, Eagan scrambling a little bit, but Hugh's been able to bump it over. Here's Hilly, over, tapped over on the right side by Miller. Back it comes to Melville. Great dig by Hilly. Weimer skirts to Alderson and over. Kennedy Orr for Hughesman. Ball dug. Weimer skirts to the middle of the floor with a great play. And Hilly gets it over. Kennedy Orr back from Melville. Hilly will set up Alderson. Orr with the dig. Kennedy Orr over. Weimer skirts to Alderson. And over by Olstead after a great run to the ball by Melville. Alderson again. And no, it's still alive and over by Eagan.
Why everybody isn't on their feet yet, I will not know. That is a monster point for Champlin Park. The Rebels with about four or five big swing opportunities. Eagan matching them blow for blow. Great defensive effort on both sides. And the ender to give him the 14-13 lead.
Allie Miller with the final kill. Here's Melville. Another dig by Hilly. Weimer skirts up for Alderson. In the middle over by Kennedy Orr. Weimer skirts Hilly to Alderson. 15-13, Champlin Park.
Hilly going counter flow from 12 feet and putting a ball on a dime for Alderson. Kelly Sheffield, you got a winner.
Melville over Hilly. Weimer skirts over by Hilly. Handled by Olstead. Brior off Weimer skirts up in the air by Claflin. And over by Battendall Vidal. Brior. Gonna run out of the court to play that. Here's Hilly back to Alderson. Melville for Brior. Spins it over the net. Dug up by Battendall Vidal. Over by Claflin. Kennedy Orr back from Melville. Hilly with a dig. Alderson back to Hilly in the middle. Another great rally. Another point this time. And the second long rally in the last few points goes to Champlin Park.
Hilly again with Midas touch as that ball turns to gold as it goes over the net. And off a waiting Hegler there. Uncharacteristic error. Hegler's going to come sit down. Wong will serve receive here. Good stall tactic here by Gillen, making sure the lineup is correct. Hall of Fame coach.
Weimer Scrooge getting ready to serve. Now we're set to go at 16-13. Brior, back throw handled by Anderson. It's Alderson over. Four straight points, Andy, for Champlin Park. Two came on those long rallies. Timeout Eagan. This could be the turning point for Champlin Park.
And especially with where they are, they've got Alderson in the three right now, which means even if there's a little bit of a comeback, we almost got Hilly back in the front row. Last game, and I believe also in set one, when the push came from Champlin, it was with Hilly in the front row, and then a little bit of relaxation from Eagan once Alderson got in the front row. So what I like seeing right now is I like the fact that it's a lot of opportunities. Everybody's taking big swings for Champlin. Eagan, not quite sure where they're going to go next here. Bree Orr hasn't been set an in-rhythm ball in quite some time. If she gets this one, look for her to uncork on one for the side out.
Remember, they were up 18-14 in that second set, Andy, and Eagan came back to tie. Very similar here, 17-13, Weimerskirk serving. Brior pushed it over. Hilly, Weimerskirch, and Alvidal. It's blocked at the net. And a point, Champlin Park.
Great decision there to get Vatndal-Vidal the swing, as Huseman was already committed on Alderson. As she gets caught in the middle, comes back and catches net.
Serve out by Weimerskirch. Point Eagan.
That's a real close serve to let go in the middle of a four-point run.
Wildcats down by four as Melville serves. Hilly for Alderson, gets blocked. Long and Huseman getting up, 18-15.
Alderson's got to stop hitting straight ahead. She's got options around the angle. That ball's off the net far enough for her to do something better with that ball. She goes right into the platform of Huseman.
Hilly back for Alderson.
Up.
Here's Wong, gets blocked. Played by Melville. Brior from Kennedy Orr with the kill. And a quick three for Eagan.
She's in seventh grade, and watch this delivery from about 18 feet away from the right side antenna. Just hucks the ball on a dime to her sister. Beautiful play, 16-18. Eagan back on a run, timeout Champlin. Champlin, breathe, guys, breathe. Go back to the little things. We just stick a pass, find a way to get our good attackers the ball. Let's take a look at this last one. Kenna, easy ball outside to Wong. Blocked, covered, picked up. Kenna now with the reversal, one-on-one, and Bree Orr's got way too much real estate to work with there. Great delivery. Champlin, look for Champlin to mix up the attack here. I'd like to see where Alderson goes. And if you're Hilly, you take a look at what the middle blocker does for Eagan and go against her. One-on-one, I think all three of these hitters can score, whether it is Vatndal-Vidal or Claflin or Alderson.
Each team with one timeout remaining here in this set. Alderson from Hilly. Dug up Olstead, scrambling, gets to it, and over by Brior. Hilly back for Alderson. Kennedy Orr back to Brior again. Very similar to that last ball. Hilly got a hand on this one, but couldn't dig it up. And now Eagan within 1 point at 18-17. A 4-0 run for the Wildcats.
Another strong finish for Bree Orr. I like this out of serve receive. They've got Alderson hitting a slide. Now she'll go quick. One on two. Oh, that ball drops.
Alderson gets the kill, and it's 19-17 Rebels.
That rotation causing problems again. We see the quick set here. Wong a little late coming in to help Huseman, and the tip over the block and down. Be a great time for an Ashburn run.
Crimble back in. Huseman swings wide. Champlin Park's at 20.
I'd like to see a commit block here back on Bree Orr from the Rebels. Let Wong go one-on-one against Alderson.
Ashburn with an ace. Leads the team in aces, and a huge one there to make it 21-17.
The ball just pops off her hand and it just keeps floating right. Melville thought she had it lined up two different times, catches herself with a crossover to finish. That's just serve a beauty right there. Great job by the Rebels. Right now they're in a good position. They're up four. They've got to hold on to finish here. We've seen way too much really good volleyball for this to not get pushed to a fourth set. It would be cheating volleyball fans all over the state. I know I'm getting blown up on my phone, people listening to the broadcast on radio and watching it live on Grand Stadium. We'll, of course, be a little delayed when it gets out on 12. This is just great volleyball. Student sections involved, parents involved. People from other matches are starting to trickle over here to see this one happen.
Out of the timeout, here's Brior. Handled by Hilly, back row, Ashburn. Right side, Alderson off of Kennedyor for a point. Big point for the Rebels to make it 22-17.
Alderson with a little drop shot here. She puts a little extra mustard, rolls it a little deeper than Kenna Orr was expecting.
Kennedy Orr outside, down for a point. Big point for Wong and the Wildcats.
Weimerskirch has had a really good match covering the whole court, and for some reason she gets sucked way in on that ball. 18-22, Eagan down by four, Champlin three away from forcing set four.
Huseman serves off the tape. Weimerskirch able to handle it. Outside it goes to Vattendahl. Vidal gets blocked. Weimerskirch to dig. Hilly back to Vattendahl. Vidal off the blockers. Eagan able to handle it. Here's Wong with the swing. Hilly the dig. Alderson right side taps it over the wide. Rebels didn't think it was wide. Ooh, see, we'll get
Let's
a great
a look.
Look here.
Tipped down. I think that caught tape. Regardless, reset side out.
Ashburn to Hilly and over. Pounded by DeSep, the Rebels able to get a piece of it. Here's Hilly pounding it. Great dig. The back roll by Melville and over for a point by Wong. How good was the play by Melville to keep that play alive?
We'll see it here. Oh, we catch up to it a little bit late there. Melville sliding forward to dig that ball. It's dug tight. Kenna Orr making a great move to get to that ball before it gets to the net. And the finish there from, I believe it was Wong. Good rally, great volleyball right now, 20-22. Eagan down by two and up 2-0. Winner of this match will play Prior Lake tomorrow at 5 p.m. If you're not excited about the volleyball happening right now, you just should probably go home or into a coma, one of the two. Great volleyball on
options.
Both sides. I mean, really, that's really all you got. Right now, Champlin needs a side out more than they need to breathe, so they can get Hilly back in the front row and so they can get that extra point and be two away from forcing a set four.
Huseman serving, her team trailing by two, but up 2-0 in sets. Here's Alderson, right side, handled by Kennedy Orr. Here's Wong over the blockers. Weimerskirch up, Alderson floats it across. Brior to middle, and this time go over. He's set in the middle. Melville trying to get to that ball and couldn't.
The pressure here, pushing the ball to the seventh grader, Kenna Orr, who does a nice job picking it up. Bree is spinning and can't find Doucette in time.
Alderson serves, but out. 23-21. Murphy in, Kenna Orr out.
Look for this serve, 1-1. Look for them to attack Alderson. I wouldn't let Hilly anywhere near this thing.
Ball goes to Hilly from Ashburn.
our seats put us in a pretty good spot to watch this happen. Oh my goodness, Hilly over the top on that ball. Nice swing.
24-21, Vattendahl with all serves. Trying to close it out here for the Rebels to force a fourth set. Alderson,
Tool,
Hilly. Champlin Park is still alive. 25-21 Rebels.
Great volleyball there as we're going to take a look at this whole point. Big serve. Olstead with a pretty good pass. Murphy pushes it deep. Ashburn digs it up. Alderson knows she's got to get it to Hilly. That ball is set tight. And Hilly sees Doucette not quite pressing. Off the block, out of bounds. Hilly playing at another level. The rest of the Rebels bringing their game up as well. Let's play four. I'd love to see this one go five. This is way too good a volleyball to be stopped short of a five-set marathon.
We'll take a break. Come back. More state volleyball from St. Paul after this.
The average text takes your eyes off the road for nearly 5 seconds.
Hey, did you buy something from some gaming site?
What do you mean?
Yeah, look, there's a bunch of different charges on here.
Do you think someone stole our credit card information?
I don't know. That site sounds familiar, though.
Yeah, isn't that the site that Billy's on all the time?
You don't think.
Billy!
Stop and think before you connect. Playing online is serious business. Visit dhs.gov/stopthinkconnect for tips on how to be safe online.
All right, give me a spot. You know my motto, safety first.
They could be dangerous. I think we should call animal control.
Animal control?
To be safe.
Don't worry. I got this. It's a new motto.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in...
Welcome back to the XL Energy Center, where we're about to see set four beginning between the Champlin Park Rebels and the Eagan Wildcats. Sid Hilly with another 7-kill set there. Alderson coming alive, getting herself another 5 kills. Great defensive effort. We got 15 digs for Hilly, 11 for Izzy Ashburn, and 15 for Weimerskirch. Obviously, the plan from Eagan had to be to go after Ashburn in that set. They may want to go away from that. That seems to be the one set they didn't pull off. Great volleyball, big swings. Weimerskirch quietly having herself a nice little day here. She's gonna be very instrumental, maybe not on first contact, but if somebody else takes one, she's going to be in charge of that second contact.
Eagan still up 2-1, Andy, but how do they reset after that one and try to get back to where they were?
I don't know that there's much that needs to be done as far as resetting. They've got to amp up. It's not where they were, because where they were in one and two is where they were in three. Champlin brought another level in three, causing us to play a set four here. They're going to need to find another level if we're going to get to that point.
Another hitting error on Eagan. 2-0 Champlin Park here to start set four. Brior the set, Murphy across to the front row, and Hilly off of Brior. Nice play by her. Here it's Wong pushing it over. Hilly handled by Olstead in the back row. Across the front row, over. And the Champlin Park player in the net this time. Point for Eagan.
Wong with really good acceleration at the end of that approach, drawing the Champlin Park block into the net.
All the Hilly blocked. Point Eagan, we are tied at 2.
Hilly trying to rip the antenna off right there, swinging real hard, just doesn't quite cut it inside far enough.
The Hilly over the blockers. 3-2 Champlin Park.
Don't need to bounce every ball. Here we see the shot tipped over the block and down in front of Bree Orr.
Here's Melville attacking. Alderson, Ashburn to Hilly. Point for the Rebels and another kill for Sid Hilly.
Hilly does a great job using the block there. Melville jumps a little early. Uh-oh, Ashburn lost something.
Looks like a contact, right?
Yeah, I think she got contact issue, which gives them, I believe it's a minute to get that figured out. Otherwise, there's got to be some sort of substitution. All these high school rules about safety kind of bother me. Here, we'll take another look at that last point here. Melville roll shots it. Now she's going to make the switch. She's late getting over, jumps a little out of position, and Hilly's able to abuse the block. And it was at that point that the contact came out. And we're back to live volleyball. Gillen's going to want an explanation as to why they get this time. And we're good.
Van Belvedere serving, her team leading by two here in set four. Murphy off of Ashburn, kill for Eagan.
When Murphy's in that rotation, she hits the two ball every time, and almost always to right back there. They may want to make an adjustment. Olstead to serve. Alderson with the pass, overpass. Murphy drops it back down. Alderson picks it up. Ashburn roll shot over from Hilly. She unloads into the net.
All set up by that serve, Andy.
Yeah, the game plan, I believe, is from Eagan to serve short and just get in the way. You watch the attackers trying to get out of the way of the passers. It's exactly what that serve is designed to do.
Ashburn will go out back to Hilly off of Hughesman for a point.
Hilly knew where she wanted to go with that ball before it was even served. Unloads, great swing here. She kind of comes in from the corner on a three. Hughesman late getting up on that ball and off the block.
Rior, back set Murphy. Ashburn up to Hilly. Another Rebels point.
Another big swing from the junior outside Wisconsin commit. We'll see it here. Goes up, and again, Hughesman late blocking. I think Melville got most of that as she's trying to swat as well. They press, it might be a different story.
Man, a good attack from Melville that time. Gets the kill for Eagan.
Melville with the inside-out approach here. Kind of doesn't get everything she has on it, so she's got to get a little shoddy, and she puts it over Hilly, who's able to get hands on it, but not well.
And Alderson from the middle, dumped over by Melville. Hilly will push it across off of Kennedy Orr point to Champlin Park.
You see McKenna Melville look at Kennedy Orr like, where were you trying to go right there, kiddo? Ah, oh, we're fine, relax, reset.
Well, back to Melville. Wayne Eagan.
Good recovery ball there as Melville gets the ball back. Big swing, Eagan within one.
This is the kind of match where you just know you're not gonna get a 25-17 game.
Anything? No.
That lopsided Alderson with the kill, 8-6 Champlin Park.
You know, the balls that they're setting to the outside are getting dug or blocked or picked up. They aren't falling for kills. It's the three zone that Champlin attacks very well right now, and Eagan not responding to it.
Weimer skirt serves. Kennedy Orr cross for Wong and off of Claflin. Point for Eagan.
Good swing there by Wong. Little bit early on the block were the Rebels, and they kind of catch themselves.
Hilly will push it back. Hughesman got to that ball and hit over. Nice play by Eagan. Now Alderson from the middle gets blocked. He's set, and Wong get up and block it. We're tied at eight.
Great block here. I like the choice to go to Alderson. And I think Doucette had been giving away that right side for the first couple sets here. Alderson goes where it had been working, and Doucette makes an adjustment on the block. Great defensive effort by the middle to start that rally as Hilly pushed to the corner.
Whitney Anderson on serve receive there. Here's Vattendahl the doll. Back it goes. Bree Orr from Kennedy Orr, too strong. Point Champlin Park. 9-8 Rebels.
Ashburn back to serve. Diddle had a nice little run in set three. Let's see if she's got another one.
To the middle, and off of Krimble, point for Eagan.
Blocker's trying to go high here instead of go over. All you got to do is press there, and she'll hit that ball into your hands, but Krimble trying to go high for some reason.
Batten to Alvidal off the blockers. Here it comes to the middle, pushed deep. Ashburn to Krimble. Dug up by Melville. Hilly back row. Ashburn back to Alderson and over. Front row Batten to Alvidal. Goes deep. Middle pushed over.
Wow.
Uh-oh. Rebels able to play it, but then push it finally too long. A long, good rally. Eagan wins that point, and they go ahead.
Murphy screaming at Melville that ball was out as Melville almost made a play on it.
Well, 10-9. Wildcats now 11-9. Rior serving. Ashburn back to Alderson off the blockers. Front row Murphy to Wong. Egan's got the biggest lead of the set. 12-9. Wildcats, the biggest lead since set two.
Fast ball from Murphy to Wong, and Alderson not able to get to the pin to close that, to set that block.
To the middle, over by Hilly. In the middle, pushed over by Doucette. Egan is up by four, 13-9. We're going to get a, maybe not timeout yet. I thought we were about a timeout point for Coach Younker. He's going to hold on for it, at least for now.
Younker looking at the up ref, not quite sure about that call, not about sure about the timeout, and they'll get the ball back as Orr serves into the net.
13-10, Alderson. Their team down by three and trailing still 2-1. Over to the middle. Doucette getting on top of that ball to pound it home.
Frenchie unloads Doucette here. Good ball from Orr to Doucette. Hilly sees it, but just can't do anything about it.
Hegwer serving. Krimble pushed it off of Olstead. Over by Murphy. Ashburn across, Hilly. Played across by Brior. Ashburn to Hilly again. And the block for the hit is out by Egan. Side out, Champlin Park.
Look for some more commit blocking here. We see it here. Hilly doesn't care, though. She's able to bounce it off the block and out of bounds.
Serve long from Batten to Alvidal. 15-11, Egan.
Can't give away points this late in the set. Olstead serving.
Ball to the middle to Hilly. Ashburn will set up Alderson. Nice play. Murphy tapping it over. Hilly. Point for Egan is off the tape, but no one from Egan touched it. Point for the Wildcats.
Hilly trying to get productive there. Now's that timeout from John Younker. Hilly doing some really nice things, just unable to finish the last couple swings she's had. When she's on the ball, it's dropping for big kills at big points. Here we see the end of this rally. Back set coming. Oh, we just lost our feed. We'll talk about it maybe in a little bit. What needs to happen right now if you're Champlin, you've got to make sure we get the finish on a swing. What's not happening is they're afraid to make the error, it seems like, which is causing some of the errors. Play loose, play calm, put a little run together yourselves. Let's see if we can't go five. Eagan looking to close out here.
This is a third of our four televised matches from the state volleyball tournament this year. Andy and I will be staying right here on court one for a 1A match. Bethlehem Academy, defending state champions in Class A, and the top seed taking on Heritage Christian Academy of Maple Grove.
Talked with some coaches yesterday, and this is the first year since they started seeding in 2008 that the top four seeds have advanced in all three classes. Zero upsets on day one.
Melville with a kill, and it's 17-11 Eagan. It's the biggest lead for either team today. Olstead floating a nice serve over. Hilly finally gets it back. That was a good run for Eagan, though, with Olstead serving in that rotation.
Yeah, nice run by them. Here we see Hilly, six hands in front of her, and she again, Huseman late on the block. She goes over a late set of hands from Huseman in the middle.
Whitney Anderson serving. Big points here for the Rebels. Eagan just eight away from taking this match. We're outside to Melville. Spins it over. Hilly got it. Takes it back from Ashburn. Or again to the middle to Huseman. One more swing for Sid Hilly and out of play. Missed on it, and Egan's up 18-12.
Hilly tries to go thumb down, cut cross, and misses that swing. Not a common error for her.
Kennedy Orr serves. Over by Miller, off of Bree Orr's hand, and then Wildcats can't recover on that. Champlin Park gets point 13.
Good, smart spot there from Miller.
Rebels trail by five. Here in set four, Kennedy Orr for Bree Orr. Off of Alderson's, Rebels kept it alive, tight at the net. Knocked over by Claflin. Weimerskirch, Hilly to Alderson. Off the blockers and down.
Great hustle from Eagan. Great offense from Champlin. Champlin will take the point here. Here we see Alderson go up. She goes off the block. Good touch by Bree Orr. Kenna and Hegwell making a move.
Bree Orr again gets blocked this time. Weimerskirch will get it up for Alderson. Her hit blocked. Hilly will set up Janae Alderson again. And a back roll by Hegwell. Over by Bree Orr to the floor, and it's a point for Egan. Bree Orr the kill.
Great defensive effort there by Hegwell. Here we see the roll shot tipped over. Alderson making a move for it. Hilly not able to make the finish.
McKenna Melville serves, a team leading by five. Hilly to Alderson. Too strong. It's Eagan at 20.
5 points away from a date with Prior Lake in the state championship. John Yunker wants to talk about it. 14-20, Rebels trail here in set four. Gonna need a good run to finish. Take a look at this last point. Hilly puts a pretty good ball out there. Alderson not able to finish her swing as she goes wide instead of deep in her transition. You gotta get back behind the ball, keep the entire court in front of you, and then unload going forward. See what happens here off this timeout. I'd like to see Alderson get the ball on a three, but we're going to need a serve receive a good clean pass in order to have that happen.
Eagan looking to close this out. They've played a solid match today, Andy.
Yeah, they have.
Wildcats team.
Clean volleyball. Love watching them play right now. Gillen, with her many years of experience, probably been coaching twice as long as Kenna Orr's been alive, giving her some last-minute feedback as they come off the court.
Except ball hit over by Miller. And Orr blocked this time in Huseman's attack. Bree Orr will push it. For a point. Tough to tell from our angle where that was, and I didn't see the flag immediately, but it is a point.
tip down the line, and oh, that ball does drop in. Anderson gets a look at it. It doesn't quite make the play, though. 4 points from state championship match.
Kalita Alderson, that one is down.
That violation 15. Causing a little bit of chaos, but Alderson will get credit with the kill as that ball goes down the line. Weimerskirt's going to need to put a little run together here.
A good serve to start it. In the middle, Huseman able to tap it over. Hilly pushing it deep. It's Wong over the blockers and got it down for a point.
Wong with that nice tip shot there. Kenna Orr pushes it out. Big hole in the middle, and Wong finds it 22-15. Eagan 3 points away.
Hilly for Battendall. Vidal, that's down.
Nice swing by the senior outside there. Excuse me, that she a junior? Junior outside.
Yeah, still just a junior. Grimble and Alderson, the seniors, among their regular rotation. The rest of these girls, like all of Egan's roster, will be back. Ashburn with the service ace. She's been so steady for them, but here it's Eagan. Now they can smell it, Andy.
2 points away, Bree Orr to serve. Inconsistent from the service line today. We'll see what she does here.
Ashburn back to Alderson. Off of Bree Orr. Champlin Park has life at 23-17. They're out of timeouts. Janae Alderson to serve.
Senior's going to need a run from the service line.
Murphy got it down off of Krimble and Battendall Vidal. What did I say? We won't see 25-17 today. We could.
We could. We could in this last set here, but it didn't have that feel getting to this point.
Hegwer trying to close it out for Eagan. Outside to Hilly. Rior will set it for Murphy. Not yet. Krimble gets the block. 24-18.
Vatnal Vidal back to serve. It starts with one for the Rebels. They don't have a 6 point play in volleyball. They need 19 here.
Vatnal Vidal just got that over. Melville gets blocked. At the net, pushed over by Hilly. Dump over by Rior. Krimble for Hilly. Melville for Murphy. Blocked. Olsted, nice job to get a hand on that ball. Ashburn for Hilly. 24-19.
I've seen crazier things happen, John Jacobson.
Champlin Park still, though, no margin for error. Back it goes, right side off of Alderson. Ashburn to the net, over by Hilly, gets blocked back. Rebels recover. Miller with the attack. Brior to the middle. The Doucette, Alderson got to that ball. Here's Hilly. Murphy with the swing, Alderson digs that ball. Ashburn for Hilly, off of Olsted. Great dig by here. Murphy off the net. And Egan's going to the state championship.
Third trip in a row for the Wildcats. They won it in 13, lost to Chaska in a sweep last year, and they'll go to play Prior Lake tomorrow for a Class 3A championship. Congratulations to the Wildcats on a great match by them. Hats off to the Champlin Park Rebels. Everything you wanted in a semifinal match. Great volleyball from both sides.
Champlin Park now 28-5 on the season. They'll play Roseville here tomorrow for third place.
Yeah, it should be another good one tomorrow. Nothing to hang your heads on if they're heads down on if you're the Rebels. Great volleyball from them today. A couple swings some kids would like to have back probably, but John Yunker should be proud of his squad, as should the entire community. Good volleyball today. We'll be back with the 1A semifinal in just a bit.
Now look for coverage of this match. It's Eagan and Prior Lake for the 3A championship. Champlin Park and Roseville for third place. That does it for our coverage of this semifinal. Terrific one from St. Paul. Eagan wins in four. For Andy Gogesberg and all of our crew, I'm John Jacobson. Thanks for tuning in for Channel 12's coverage of the high school volleyball tournament.